Namaskar to everyone. I come back to the words that you started with, nervousness. How does one speak in the middle of so many achievers? As a journalist, I'm only somebody who chronicles other people's work. I'm used to only questioning others. I'm only used to asking others to answer my questions. To talk on my own is really a tough task. But spirituality, I just wish I could take all of you to a newsroom of a television channel. And you would, believe me, forget the spelling of spirituality. Because it is, I'm sorry to say this, but it is such a dog-eat-dog world there. You bring in a breaking news, next minute somebody's, as we call it in our lingo in the newsroom, chapoed it from your channel onto their channel. So that is spirituality for you. The minute you get exclusive information and you put it out first in exclusive on Times Now, next minute nobody bothers to check. If somebody's put it on Times Now, it must be right. Pick it up, line to line, word to word, copy it, paste it. It's on the other channel. They don't have to work hard for it. They can just pick it up, paste it there, and call it first and exclusive on that channel. So that's the world that I come from. And in that world, to think of spirituality is a completely misplaced emotion, because it just doesn't come out. You know, everybody's out there to take somebody's eyes out of their sockets and just get there first. And believe you me, I know there is competition in every profession. We live in a competitive world. But in a television channel, it's every minute. Every single minute of your existence is competition, and you have to get it there first. Guruji has to give an interview to Times Now first. He can't give it to anybody else. And there would be dead bodies on the news floor if he goes to some other channel. So that's how it is in our newsroom. If there is a picture of some Ram Mandir Ayodhya negotiation going on, it has to be on my channel first. That's the way we are. Now, in that world, how do you bring in spirituality? I'll just tell you my own experience. I worked in print. I started off in print from Economic Times to the Indian Express. I worked in print for 15 years. I wrote stories, I was doing investigative journalism. And then I got this huge so-called break because there was a gentleman who was starting a channel called Times Now, and he kept calling me for 3 months. And I wasn't interested in leaving print and going to television, but he kept calling me that television so far is very fluffy as a medium. We need to get the substance of print and get it to television to make television an in-depth medium, to bring in the investigation and the stories to television. So why don't you join me? And I said, I'm not going to do all the running about with a camera on my shoulder. I'm not doing it. You know, in television, in print, you get a story, you file it from home, and then you are with your kids doing their homework, doing their 12 standards, screaming at them, getting them to work, all that goes on. But in television, your work begins after you've got the story. Because then that story has to be worked upon, it has to be visualized, it has to be converted from a print piece of paper into an audio-visual medium. There are sound bites that you have to get. You have to add a whole lot of body. So work begins after you've got the story. So I said, I'm not interested in that. And I'm 39. You know, at 40, people are leaving television and coming back to print. Why would I do television at that age? And he said, no, come in. So I thought, Okay, for 3 months he's been chasing me, and I was at that time in Australia, and my phone was costing me a lot. So to cut a long conversation short, I just told him, okay, when I come back to India, I'll meet up with you. And one thing led to another, and I said, okay, I'll give myself a year in television. Let me try a new medium. And that was 13 years ago when I joined Times Now. And I started, and it was that day that everybody, when I joined television, told me, you've made the biggest mistake of your life. It's the wrong age, and you're the wrong kind of journalist to do it, because you do investigative stories, you do journalism that's based on documents from inside ministries, you take out files. All that doesn't work on television. Television is a frothy medium. It works on, you know, peppy stuff, young stuff, trendy stuff. It doesn't work on serious stuff. And I said to myself that I'll make it work. I'll make it work in the wrong age. I'll make it work in the wrong kind of stories that I do. And that was my spirituality. And I told them, will not be part of the rat race. I will not be running with a mic behind every single human being that I see anywhere in the world. And that's how the journey started. Even today, when I'm in the newsroom, I'm looking for that something different. I'm not part of the run-of-the-mill grind that's going on. That's my spirituality. That's where I found my space. I will not run over bodies and climb over shoulders to get to the top. I have worked my way up over 13 years. I try to find my spirituality in my contentment. My contentment doesn't mean that I will not do work, but my contentment means that this is the work that satisfies me. And this is the quality of work that I will do. That is my spirituality. At the same time, I don't think we are passing a value judgment, because the other kind of work also needs to get done, because it's all kinds that takes. But for that, you need other people with other talents to do it. But for myself, my spirituality is to be there, not lose it, but keep giving the quality of work. That is my spirituality. So how to make it fashionable? It's very difficult, believe you me. I really urge each of you, whenever you get an opportunity, to come to a newsroom of a television channel, to understand that spirituality is the furthest thing from our minds, because it's so competitive and it's so immediate all the time that there is no time to think about anything like spirituality. In the middle of that, to find your focus, your quality, your purpose, and that's very important. In my 13-year-old journey, it's been very fulfilling. When I came into this hall, people came up to me in the presence of Madhuji to say that they watch my show and they wanted a photograph of me. That truly is touching, because we have a film star here who's done phenomenal work. We have achievers, I mean somebody who's an author, somebody who's a CEO of a company, somebody who's made in India a brand name in Chanel and Dior. I mean, these kind of achievers, in the middle of that, if somebody can come and say that we watch you and we... It's very, very touching to know that my spirituality is to take what your question might be through my show to the people who need to answer that question. That is my spirituality. So spirituality, as Madhuji said, is not to cut yourself off and sit in a corner and meditate. That's not the spirituality that we can be part of. we have to find our spirituality in the middle of the madness where we are. And really, it is the mad, mad world of a television newsroom where I've managed to find my spirituality. In the middle of a mad running day, I link up with my kids. I still take days off when my kids have exams. That's my spirituality. And through my kids, I'm sitting in the office while a breaking story is going on. I'm breaking stories, I'm doing my graphics, I'm doing my questions, I'm doing my research, and organizing a birthday party for my kid and his friends. That's my spirituality, because my role as a mother is as important to me as my role as a journalist, as a news hound. And my spirituality also comes from the fact that I'm not a studio human being. Even now, as I keep telling my younger reporters in the newsroom, don't be in the glamour of the studio. Chappal ragad ke ministries ke chakkar nahi lagaoge to story nahi milegi. You have to know what you are going after, the corridors of power, because I do that kind of reporting, that kind of investigative journalism. If you're covering an election, if you're not on the streets covering the rallies, if you're not talking to people, you will not get the sense of the ground reality. You will report what you're reading in newspapers, and that's never going to be something that is going to be a substitute for the real life experience. So that's, in our work, that's the spirituality. I have gone to villages, stayed there, lived with people there to get a sense of what's the political pulse. That's my spirituality. So spirituality, I don't know if it's fashionable or not. In my world, it's not a word that's used very often. In fact, probably it's most out of fashion in my world. But it's something that I introduce peer group to say that don't be running after the same thing. If somebody is copying you, let him be. Get another big story. Get a story based on something that he will never be able to access. That's your spirituality, and that's your depth, and that's your real gain and your real achievement as a reporter. So I think in the work that we do, we have to find our own spirituality, our own space in the way we are leading our own lives. We have to find our spirituality. And I can tell you, even today, I have a 26-year-old son and a 17-year-old son. I can give a beginner a run for their money in the amount of energy I can bring to the table versus what they can bring to the table. So that's my spirituality. It's only because I have the passion for it. My passion is news. My passion is my story. My passion is what I do. I wouldn't do anything else but what I do. There have been options. People tell me, come and join the World Bank, come and join a company, have a relaxed life, have a 9-to-5 job, but it's not something I would do. So this is my passion, and if you have passion, that would be your spirituality.